In this video, I am going to explain about the impedance transformation relation. We know that from the root of the equation V equal to V plus into e power minus gamma L plus V minus into e power gamma L. From this, I can take V plus e power minus gamma L as common, and I can write this as V minus e power gamma L by V plus into e power minus gamma L. I know that this is equal to the reflection coefficient, as we already derived this, a voltage backward by voltage forward in my previous video. So simply I can write this as, V plus e power minus gamma L times of 1 plus rho of L. This indicates that the reflection coefficient at any length. And before doing the derivation, first everyone should know what is meant by impedance transformation relation. Suppose if you are given with a network like this, and I have given a load or the impedance at certain length L, and you are supposed to find, or you are asked to find some impedance at another length L. So to find a impedance at another point, you can use this impedance transformation relation to easily evaluate at any given point or at any asked point to find the impedance. So it is very easy. And similarly, I can write I of L, voltage at any length, and I at any length as V plus by Z naught. And similarly, by taking common, instead of plus here I will get minus, and the same repeats. So I can write directly as 1 minus rho of L. Instead of solving, from this I can write directly as 1 minus rho of L, where this is the reflection coefficient at any length. So simply now I can write Z of L equal to V of L by I of L, which is equal to Z naught times of 1 plus rho of L by 1 minus rho of L. And this is also one of the important relation, which is intermediate one. Now we have to proceed further. So similarly, like we did in an earlier video, where we use a componendo and dividendo to find a rho from this equation by sending Z naught to the left hand side part and applying the componendo and dividendo relation. Similarly, I can send Z naught to this side. It will be Z of L by Z naught, which is equal to 1 plus rho of L by 1 minus rho of L. And by applying componendo and dividendo, from this I can get rho of L equal to impedance at any length minus impedance characteristic impedance by Z of L plus Z naught. These two are similar and these two are equal also. In fact, I obtained this expression from this. Now I can write Z of L equal to this. A reflection coefficient at any point is equal to V minus by V plus into e power minus 2 gamma L, where this is equal to the reflection coefficient at L equal to 0. As I already explained in my previous video, you can see that at L equal to 0, I got simply by substituting V L equal to 0, V minus by V plus. So I can write in this V minus by V plus as rho L, and I can replace rho of L, or the reflection coefficient at any length L can be replaced as Z naught times of 1 plus rho L into e power minus 2 gamma L. I can write this as the characteristic impedance at load end, means at L equal to 0, into e power minus 2 gamma L by 1 minus rho L into e power minus 2 gamma L. Now if you clearly see, I can write rho L as, from my previous video I derived by using componendo and dividendo, this is nothing but rho L. So in the place of rho L, I can write ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0. Now I will replace this in this formula. So now my Z of L will be equal to Z0 times of 1 plus ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0 into e power minus 2 gamma L by 1 minus ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0 into e power minus 2 gamma L. Now I will multiply both numerator and denominator with e power gamma L. Now what will happen is e power gamma L into 1 is e power gamma L plus ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0 into e power minus 2 gamma L into e power gamma L will be e power minus 2 gamma L into e power gamma L. This will be e power minus 2 gamma L plus gamma L, which is equal to e power minus gamma L. So here I will get e power minus gamma L by e power gamma L, same here, minus ZL minus Z0 by ZL plus Z0 into e power minus gamma L. This whole term will be multiplied with Z0. Now if I will take LCM, then it will be e power gamma L into ZL plus Z0 plus ZL minus Z0 into e power minus gamma L by this one. Here if you take LCM, here I will get ZL plus Z0 and here also ZL plus Z0 multiply term, and these two will cancel in the numerator and denominator. So if you simplify and if you apply these two formulas, cos h gamma L equal to, from trigonometric hyperbolic trigonometric functions, it is equal to e power gamma L plus e power minus gamma L by 2, and sin h of gamma L equal to e power gamma L minus e power minus gamma L by 2. If I substitute these two, means if you take common here, e power ZL, if I take common in both the terms, then I will get ZL into e power gamma L plus e power minus gamma L, and if I divide by 2 in both, on both numerator and denominator, 1 by 2 1 by 2, then I will get a load impedance or a impedance at any length L. I will get as Z of L equal to Z0 into ZL cos H gamma L plus Z0 sin H gamma L by Z0 cos H gamma L plus ZL sin H gamma L. Since the time is exceeding, I didn't calculated all in front of you in this video, but I explained almost, I took you to the end of the derivation, that if you take common ZL in both the terms, then if you will rewind with the terms e power gamma L plus e power minus gamma L, and as I multiplied with 1 by 2, I will get by 2 term here, and if I take common Z0, then e power gamma L minus e power minus gamma L by 2. So by substituting in the place of that, these two terms, I will finally obtain with this relation, that is a load impedance or the impedance at any length L. So finally, this is a very important derivation, and from this we will define three important characteristics by using this formula, and this is the formula, and this is also called as the impedance transformation relation. If impedance at any point is given, and if you ask it to find at any length L in the line, suppose this is your generator and this is your load end, and if you ask it to find at any point impedance at any length L or at any distance from the load or from the generator, you can easily find the impedance at that point by using this formula. So this is called as impedance transformation relation, and that's all for this video. And if you divide this with Z0, if you take Z0 common in both, then that is called as a normalized impedance, and I will explain that in the next video. And that's all for this video, and see you in the next one. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more videos.